Let's take a closer look at mid-compact binoculars. But first, let's just take a look at those numbers that we see on binoculars. That's the numbers that look like an equation. Here are the numbers from a typical mid-compact binocular that's ideal for general purpose viewing. The first number, the 8, tells us the magnification is 8 times. This means the object we are viewing will be 8 times larger in the binocular view when compared with the naked eye view. Another way of thinking about this is that the object is 8 times closer. Imagine that you are looking at someone 100 metres away. In the binocular, they will seem as though they are standing only 12.5 metres away. The second number, the 32, is simply the size of the objective lenses in millimetres. That's the lenses at the front here. There are no hard and fast rules, but the mid-compact category starts at around about 30 millimetres and goes up to about 40 millimetres. Any larger and they begin to merge with full-size binoculars. Weight-wise, the serious mid-compact started around about 360 grams, so very convenient to carry. There are two basic types of mid-compact binocular, the traditional poroprism and the more modern roof prism. You can see that all other things being equal, the roof prism are more compact, and they tend to be slightly more expensive than the same specification roof prism. But at our prices, that's probably not a major worry. The majority of mid-compact binoculars are of the roof prism type. So our first recommendation then in a mid-compact is that an ideal size for general purpose use would have an objective of 32 millimeters. The main benefit of the mid-compact binocular is that they offer a standard of performance that approaches the full-size binocular, but in the smallest, lightest possible package. Good mid-compacts can usually be fitted in a man's jacket pocket. The reduced size of optics found in the mid-compacts means they don't have the full light-gathering power of the full-size models and don't perform as well in deep twilight. But they are large enough to give bright views still in overcast lighting, and most importantly for bird watchers, they still give good views in early twilight when birds are roosting. So if size and portability are an issue, but you still want as much big binocular performance as you can get, opt for a middle of the road mid-compact binocular. So let's sum up our look at mid-compacts with a few recommendations. For general bird and wildlife watching on the move, select optics in the 30 to 40 millimeter range and magnifications no higher than 10 times. Our ideal recommendation would be an 8x32. I hope you found that useful. Bye for now.